Hello, welcome. Thank you for taking a look at LaunchDarkly. Today, I'm going to show you a handful of ways that you're able to transform your software delivery process for the better by implementing LaunchDarkly's feature management solution. So here's how. First thing that we're going to do is decouple our deploy from our release. Feature flags act as a gate after your code has been deployed. This enables you to turn features on and off as you see fit, so you're able to push code on demand regardless of when the release is ready. This also enables product teams and marketing teams to have more control over their feature releases. LaunchDarkly's feature management platform gives you granular control over who you are releasing your features to. So remember how I said feature flags can kind of act as a gate? Well, you can open and close that gate as little or as much as you would like by doing a percentage rollout or even targeting based on custom attributes like region or email so that you're able to target or beta test a specific subset of users. We're then able to run A/B tests on feature flags to determine exactly how our releases are impacting our business. We do this by tying in key business and performance metrics to existing feature flags. This lets us make more informed decisions and provide our users with a more positive experience. So, now that we know our goals, let's walk through how we actually make this all work through LaunchDarkly's easy-to-use interface, which you can see here on the left. Now on the right, I have a LaunchDarkly demo site, which is retrieving our feature flag evaluations through one of our many supported SDKs. So let's say that we want to release a new chatbox feature onto this demo site. Well, the code for this feature has actually already been deployed and wrapped in a feature flag. Now that we're ready to release our feature to the world, it's as simple as toggling a switch from off to on. Thanks to LaunchDarkly's streaming architecture, we see our change occur within about 25 milliseconds. This technology is scalable too, as we serve around 3 trillion flags to our customers every single day. Now, unfortunately, when it comes to our chatbox feature, it seems like it wasn't quite ready for production. However, rather than trudging through a painful rollback procedure or pushing out a hasty code fix, we can just toggle this feature back to off and have our customers seeing a positive experience again. All it takes to go ahead and turn something back off with LaunchDarkly, letting you very easily test out features independently. Now, next time we go to release this, maybe we want to do some testing first and make sure things are actually working before we turn it on for everybody. So to do that, we'll hop into our chatbox feature, and we're just going to add an individual user to our enable chatbox variation. Now we're just going to target based off of email here, so I'm going to add my QA engineer's email, which just so happens to be johntest@demo.com. We'll switch our default rule to false, so we're serving our disable chatbox to everyone else, turn targeting back to on, and see how this impacts our site. We see flag saved successfully, however this time there is no chatbox showing up, and that's because I've not signed in as our targeted user. So if we do that very quickly, we'll simply target our QA engineer's email, and now we can see our feature enabled for just the one individual that we specified. This is a really powerful way to test features out in real production environments without the risk of serving your customers a negative experience. Now, let's take this one step further, and we can even add a beta group to our enable variation. To do that, it's as simple as targeting based on attributes. These attributes are anything you have context of within your application. So often this is information coming from a data store or maybe a user session. So first thing that we'll do is just select the attribute we want to target on. Let's say we want to make a beta group and go ahead and test out a whole list of users. So we want to target based on an account type is one of, and we'll say beta. Make this a little bit more complex. We'll say this is a North American beta group, so we'll also target on a region such as country, and we'll say country is United States, Canada, or Mexico. And so if these conditions are satisfied, we'll go ahead and serve our enable chatbox. And so that's really all we have to do to go ahead and create a complex beta group. If we want to, we can even convert this to a segment, so we're able to drag and drop this beta group into other features as we see fit. So we've seen how we decouple our code deployment from our feature release so that we're able to push code on demand and then go ahead and release it as we see fit. And we've also seen how we can have more control over our release audience by targeting specific users or even targeting entire groups of users just based on the attributes that you have access to. Now, let's talk about how we can do some data-driven experimentation by taking an existing feature flag and associating some metrics with it. So creating an experiment with LaunchDarkly is as simple as taking an existing feature flag that is already acting as a decision point in your code and tying some metrics into the different decisions that are being made. So back in our demo site, I've got an example here where we can see a pricing page that is offering a free 21-day trial. Now this trial duration is actually controlled by a feature flag, which is randomly serving our users a 14, 21, 30, or 45-day trial. We can see our trial offer change here as we refresh the page. So where we did see 21, we now see 14. Okay, so like I said, we need to tie in some business metrics that we actually want to track in regards to the different decisions we're serving our users. So there are two metrics that we want to track with this experiment. The first being started registration, which is an event that gets sent when we click on this big green button here. That's an event that's fired off. Now, our second metric that we care about here is registered. This is an event that fires when we fully register for a trial and hit our submit button here. So what does it look like when we actually create this experiment? And how do we analyze our results? So back in the LaunchDarkly platform, if we go over to the experiment section, we can hit this big blue button to go ahead and create an experiment. This is going to take us through a very easy to use experiment builder that provides a nice workflow that provides you with all the steps that you actually need to take to go ahead and spin up a new experiment. So we'll just give this a name of my experiment. And then we'll say our hypothesis is that increasing trial duration will lead to increased conversion. We hit next, and then we select the particular metrics that we're interested in tracking with this experiment. Like we said just a moment before, the primary metric that we care about here is registered, whether a user has fully submit us their information. Now, when I select this, you can see that this is a conversion type metric. We also support numeric metrics as well as page view and click metrics. Let's go ahead and add our secondary, which is our started registration. We'll go ahead and click next. And here we define our variations, which is where we specify a particular feature flag that is serving the variations that we want to go ahead and track our metrics on. In this case, it's our trial duration feature flag. Once we select that, we can see the variations that it's already serving, knowing that this is what we're going to be going ahead and experimenting on. We'll click next, and here's where we define the audience. So this is where we either specify the random percentage of all of our users that we want to be served this experiment, or we can even target a subset of users like we were earlier with our overall feature, and go ahead and just experiment on maybe people who have opted into a beta group. We'll go ahead and hit finish here, and that's really all it takes to set up an experiment. So what does it look like now that this is created? Let's take a look at our results and get an idea of what an experiment that has been running for a while actually looks like. So we'll hit our trial duration here. If we go over to our results page, we can see some key information that will help us make a decision on what we should be showing our customers. We use a Bayesian model of statistics, and this very quickly shows us which variation has the probability to be best. Once we've picked a winning variation, like our 30 days here, it's as simple as going back to our feature flag. We can click right here, go back over to targeting, and then go ahead and just progressively roll this out to an increased section of our user base so that we're able to very slowly go and roll this out to 100% and make sure that 30 days really is our best variation. And that's it. You're now ready to deliver impactful code faster with less risk and more confidence that you're making the right business decisions. Thank you so much for taking the time to learn about LaunchDarkly.